All right, here it is. It's actually a pretty nice cart.
Yeah, it's not bad at all.
So the guys at the shop are really busy with the Jeep. I grabbed a golf cart from the junkyard, brought it over to my house, and I'm getting ready for the Bronco upgrade.
I already ordered the other body, so all we gotta do is get this one off.
These kits I found online turn regular golf carts into replica golf cars. I just strip down the old cart and build the new one on the existing frame.
You gotta get this off and leave the electronics in it so we can put that on the new body. And that's really it, man.
Taking the body off this thing is a two-person job. So I invited my neighbor Randy over to help. He's all about working on cars. The Bronco golf cart kit has finally showed up at my house.
I'm really chomping at the bit to get this thing done. I'm super excited about it. Tommy and the guys are really busy, so I'm gonna do it in my own shop, gonna knock it out right here, do it myself. It'll look great.
Don't even tell me that this is wrong.
So I started putting the motor in, slid in really easy, no problems there. I went to go put on the front end. And I realized that there is not a single bracket on this thing to hold this front end together. It is completely void.
What the?
There is no way I'm gonna be able to do this by myself.
Man.
I definitely bit off more than I can chew. I gotta get some help.
Whoa, 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 whoa. This Bronco golf cart has gone from a fun, quick build to a major pain in the ass.
There's no instructions. There's a lot of fiberglass work. I definitely bit off more than I can chew.
Man. I hate to admit it, but I need some help. So I'm pulling Tommy away from the Jeep just to help get me started.
All right, man, here it is.
The body is cool, man. I knew it was gonna be a little bit of a struggle trying to mount this. I was hoping you weren't gonna kill yourself getting this thing on there.
They said it was bolt on. They lied.
Yeah.
There's no instructions, and there's nothing that bolts on. Nothing, zero, zip, zilch.
Great.
Yeah, so we need to make up all the new brackets for that.
Yeah, there is absolutely zero. Nothing there.
Zero, I was thinking about coming off the front bumper and making a bracket that goes up to the...
Yeah, it's gonna need a lot more than just bolting this thing on, man. Man, as much stuff as we have at the shop, do you really wanna stop right now and put this kind of time into this thing?
Yep.
This golf cart project is certainly pretty cool, but it's not like a turnkey deal. I mean, Andy thought he was just gonna look through a catalog, buy something cool and stick it on there, and he quickly found out that that was not the case.
The good news is that we're doing it together and we get some quality time, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm running Tommy all over town, but he is the mastermind behind most of our builds and the fix-it man when something goes wrong. And right now, this golf cart is going wrong.
That doesn't sound good.
No, that doesn't sound good.
I'm not sure this is gonna be the moneymaker I thought. Nothing is lining up the way it should.
Here's our problem. Look when you're sitting and driving it.
We got a seat?
Yeah. But look, I mean, it almost looks like it needs to come back.
It does need to come back. I agree with that.
But if it came back 3 inches, that means we gotta slide the body back 3 inches.
Yeah, you know, and the body line's not even remotely close.
Every part we pick up has a problem with it. This is a nightmare.
Oh, that's just stupid. There's no way, man. We can't leave the steering wheel up higher than the windshield.
No.
What?
You can't build a quality product. Why build anything?
And we're also gonna need to find out that the seat doesn't fit.
Are you kidding me?
Nope, I am not kidding you. Come on, man, give us something over here. You gotta be kidding me, man, something. Steering column doesn't even remotely fit, the body doesn't fit, and now the seats don't fit. I mean, you know, do we wanna break it or do we wanna get it in there?
You gotta be kidding me. This thing definitely was not as easy as they made it seem. No instructions, it didn't fit right. I mean, a whole bunch of brackets had to be made for it. Dude, that's just, I mean, every single part we've gotten so far has been wrong.
Yeah, it's just gonna break.
I don't even know.
Wow.
Whenever I think I have a sure thing, that's when the headaches start.
Oh, that did not sound good.
How about this?
All right.
Let's put the lift kit on, put the wheels, you know, put the tire on it, and make sure that everything looks square in the wheel wells before we start.
That makes sense. Are those instructions?
Gotta love it when you get pictures. That is nice.
There's control arms, shock mounts. I'm gonna try and lift the front end up. Will you set the jacks underneath the aluminum?
That's a bit big.
Oh, these shocks are wasted.
Yeah, so it says remove the A-arm from here, so this guy needs to come off too.
So the lift kit we put on was a pretty cool little setup. You actually drop the entire front suspension out, you take off the hubs. You put the old hubs onto the new suspension, bolt it all back up in there, voila, 6 inches taller. I think the body's in the right spot, so we're gonna go ahead and put the back lift kit on right now, get the rear tub set, and we should be looking pretty good.
All right, well, it's there.
This way's faster.
All right. Where does the bracket go? Where was the shock? Shock was there. Hand me a bracket and the U-bolts.
But then you got nothing to hold that too.
Yeah, something's a mess.
But we got another bracket?
Nope, you got those two brackets. That's it. You got a lot of nuts and bolts here, though.
Probably should be a bolt there. That probably should bolt back in.
Everything fit on nice and easy, just the way it should. Thank God.
All right, that's pretty much on.
The only problem that I have is I have all these parts that are left over. There shouldn't be any parts left over. I shouldn't have extra screws and extra bolts. What do these go to?
I mean, that's an awful lot of leftover nuts and bolts.
Yeah, it is an awful lot of nuts and bolts left over. I'm waiting for something to fall off.
Actually, that's
looking good.
Yeah,
that's right there. It took us a little while, but little by little, we finally figured out how to make this card come together. It's finally coming around.
Look at that.
It is on like Donkey Kong, man.
Yep, slide her back a little bit. There we go.
Look at that, she's good now.
That is good.
So Tommy and I got a ton done on this thing today.
All right, let's throw this puppy on.
We got the front tub mounted.
We're pretty close, man.
Yeah. It's all fitted.
I think that's as good as you're gonna get that, my friend.
And I am really happy with the work we got done.
I think we got a windshield. Damn, I'm digging it.
I should be able to take care of the rest of the stuff myself. A little bit of body work, send it over to paint. This thing should be a breeze from here on out.
All right, man. Have fun.
I'm heading over to Andrew's. He says he's got the golf cart done. I'll believe it when I see it.
Andrew.
What are you doing, Dad?
I came to see the golf cart.
It's here. You want to see it?
Yeah, that's what I'm here for.
Come on.
I've already promised some of my friends we can deliver on these fancy golf carts. I just don't want Andrew to make me look bad. It wouldn't be the first time he's done it to me.
Oh, man.
There it is.
That is really something.
Isn't that awesome? Jacked it up, put a lift kit on it.
Scoop, windshield.
Wheels, tires, handmade bumpers. Handmade the dash. I mean, we did so much custom work. This thing, it was ridiculous. It's like nobody else's, I can tell you that.
And that's what they're looking for.
Yeah.
They don't care about the money. Yeah. They want people to turn around and look at it.
We did a lot of work.
I can sell this, Andrew.
Yeah, and it rolls. It'll do like 15 miles an hour.
This thing's got a tailgate and a workable
one. Yeah, look.
Oh, man.
Isn't that awesome?
They're going to love this.
Yep, throw your golf clubs in the back. You're good to go.
They are going to love this.
It's awesome.
It was hard to believe how well it came out.